I don't want to like be. Oh shit, we gotta play his theme song. Holy shit. Switchblade, you need to get on me when it comes to not playing these theme songs. And Eddie Kingston making his debut. This his first official match in Combat League. And he came out when Punk was facing Okada. Okada winning that match, and Kingston surprising Combat League, surprising the arena, gets in the ring and drops Punk with a spinning back fist. And we heard these two exchange words. Kingston says there's unfinished business between these two, and Ric Flair gonna let these two settle things tonight in the opening of All American Combat. And man, we're just, this is night two, man. How, talk about night one, what a night. New champion Britt Baker, which we will be hearing from the new Combat League women's, or the new Combat League World Singles champion later tonight. But let's talk about that hellacious unified combat match. The third ever unified combat in the history of Combat League. And Hook, Roman Reigns, Cody Rhodes, and Terry Funk were able to walk out of unified combat in one piece, beating the Hidden Blade, Jey Uso, and James Storm. Oh, this is not the right one. Not bad. Oh, there's Toxic Nova with the production miscues. And these two, they're gonna settle their differences in this Combat League ring tonight. Could you imagine a world where Eddie Kingston and CM Punk is the opening match on a pay-per-view? Whatever that pay-per-view is, I would love to watch it, because I could only imagine what the main event would be. Shit, Combat League against Josh Alexander and Seth Rollins. That's a match that I legit would love to see in real life. Hey, that's okay with me. That's okay with me, Grizz. Punk changed. Boyman Red started playing Punk after the guy that was originally playing Punk got removed from Combat League. And Boyman Red hit me up and he was like, hey man, I hope it's not too much of an issue, but I don't really want to do the straight edge thing. Can I go back to Best in the World Punk? I was like, yeah, for sure, dude. But I wanted to finish things up with Slim. And Eddie Kingston in control of this match. Big fists, big punches on the down Punk. And Kingston took it right to Punk. As soon as the bell sounded, I mean, these two just, again, there's no love loss here. So Spectrum, unless Spectrum's coming back, I don't think we have a Darby Allin. There is no Adam Cole either. So Toxic Nova, I was told by Taken Vandal that he DM'd you about what I had discussed with him. And I don't want to talk too much about it in the stream because I don't want people to like, oh, what are you guys talking about? But I'm pretty much like, if we do this match, that's the stipulation. We have to go. I think given the context of the storyline and everything that's happened, it has to be an all or nothing situation. Right hands from Kingston. If you guys don't want to do it, that's fine. We can come up with something else. But if we go that route, that's kind of where I want to go. Kingston has Punk on the ropes and just still all over him. Big DDT there from Kingston. And look, Kingston not even looking for that pinfall. Just picking Punk back up in a springboard for him to the back of the neck. Oh, my bad. Blizzard, good call out, man. Y'all got to understand, I'm like operating about 3 hours behind everyone. And we're just going to chalk this up to ate too many vegetables and drank too much whiskey. And I'm actually going to eat some vegetables before the main event starts.
He hightails it to ringside. Certainly has to be piecing together a new game plan now.
I finished. We don't have to do it, though. That's the thing. It's your choice. Like, if you guys say, no, I don't want to do that, I'm not going to be okay, well, I'm never using your wrestlers again. We'll come up with something else. We'll keep doing what we're doing. But if we go that route, if that's the route you guys do want to go, I really think we should do that stipulation. Knee from Punk landing right on Kingston. Punk back in control now that things are on the outside. And Punk was being tossed into that barricade. I told you these two were going to beat the hell out of each other. Not going to talk about it, Grizzly. Me tossing Nova and taking Vandal, we've been cooking. They've been in my creative offices. Is it, if this match goes to a disqualification, I'm not letting it happen. We're at an 8 count. They're going to have to get back in that ring. Look, they both stop what they're doing. Get back in there. And a big forearm from Kingston once again. And Kingston goes for another pin. Punk this time kicking right out. And so far, Kingston has been the aggressor in this match, and it's worked in his favor. I'm going to do what Bucket suggested. We'll do predictions. Instead of predicting the exact winner, you're going to predict a range of numbers. So we'll do, you know, one vote will be 1 through 5. The other vote will be 6 through 10. Third vote will be 11 through 15. Final vote will be 16 through 20. And then if the number within that range wins the battle royal, you win the bet. I think it's a really good idea. Bucket suggested that, and it makes a lot of sense. I don't know why I never thought about that before. As soon as I read that, I was like, well, fuck, man, that's like a really good idea. Big kicks from Punk right across the forehead, and you are exactly right, Spectrum. This is a brawl. Oh, my God. Ty-Dye's here. You know it's a good night when your homegirl Ty-Dye comes through. And, bruh, I've seen you been going active on Diablo 4, so a brother just got to ask, when is he going to get an invite? When is he going to get an invite? I want to fight the hordes of hell with my homegirl. Unless we ain't cool like that no more, which if that's the case, my bad. I thought we were good people. I guess we ain't. I guess we ain't like that, huh? And Kingston showed her up. Dude, this is a good match. I'm loving this match. Missile dropkick straight to Kingston. Kingston not even able to get back to his feet, eating that punch. And now, Kingston big right hand. I haven't even finished the first act. I'm sorry, let me rephrase that. I haven't even finished the campaign. I'm on act 4. We just had a really big run at work where I was just working all the time. I haven't really had a chance to sit down. I'm on a little 6-day vacay. It started Wednesday, and I go back Wednesday. Well, really started Thursday, and I go back Wednesday. So as soon as this stream's over, I'm definitely getting on my PC. Oh, I think I'm like level 50, somewhere around there. Dude, Crono, Frango Mac went nuts. I'm just waiting for Don Moxley to help Eddie and Punk big pile driver center of the ring. Just spiking. Yeah, that is Craig O'Mac.
That's really as close as it gets.
Two count, dude. Okay, they're going to war here. What a war this has been between Punk and Kingston. And this is just the first match of the night. And now Punk goes to the top. It's clobber time! And look, just showing it. Watch the bottom. This is the elbow. Kingston roll. And there I am already yelling. Oh, he tried spinning back knuckle. Punk ducks. Big chop across the chest. Power slam from Punk. And Punk, no. Chop, nope. Kingston ducks. Big. That almost caught him just right under the throat. And now Punk. No forearm from Kingston fighting out of that wrist lock. And that's like trap. There's an exploder suplex from Kingston. Punk just launched across the ring. Spinning back knuckle. No, fuck! Punk kicks, high kick, rocking Kingston. That's fine. However you want to do it, Katana. That works for me. Punk taunting to the crowd and stomping on the back of the shoulder. And look at Punk just kicks to the side of the face, man. These two just, there is No love between these two. I definitely gotta tone down his aerial sliders. Kingston has done more springboards in this match than he's done his whole career. Kingston takes the back in a... Oh no, looked like a back suplex into a side slam instead. And a dragon screw from Kingston and straight up working on the knee. And look at Kingston now going to the top. A little uncharacteristic there from Eddie Kingston, the Mad King. Waiting for Punk to get to his feet. Kingston off the top. My goodness, he just comes crashing down. Big forearm from Eddie Kingston. And a right hand taking Punk off his feet. Oh, I think Kingston thinks he has the crosshairs. And down a fitting back fist. Rocket Punk. And Punk showed her up. Are you kidding? I thought Kingston had it there. I thought that was the end. All right, I can't be doing that. Can't be doing that. Elbow from Punk fighting out of the corner. Big leg Larry taking Kingston off his feet. Right hand, nope. Right hand from, but these two are still exchanging those punches. And a brain buster from Kingston. And look at Kingston, he's just filling himself after. And a big discus punch.
Lifting them up, relative ease.
And a second to follow. And look at Kingston just taunting the crowd now after.
He's lining him up. Take off.
And a second for him from the top. And Kingston says that's it. And he said, I think he believes he has Punk where he wants him. And Jay now just really filling himself in this ending frame here. Look at those punches, those combinations. Just tagging Punk up, man. Punk is in a precarious position here. And a Kumagoye knee.
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE.
And if I'm Kingston, I'm going for a pin here, but no. This is more than a match for Kingston, and that's what's gonna cost him. As he gets that grapple, that mounted position reverse, and eats those forearms, and now Punk working on the ankle. And now Punk going back to the top. And another elbow, this time it connects right on the shoulder blade of Eddie Kingston, and Punk goes for the pin. He can have it right here, and Punk and expertly goes for the finish and gets the win over Eddie Kingston. Kingston could have had it had he went for the finish, and instead just taking his time, really just wanting to fight Punk, and he paid for it at the end. And Punk, I mean, just Punk's banged up. I like that ending. I know that ending's good because Kingston had the match won, right? Kingston had the match won. But he chose not to go for the pin. He just kept beating the shit out of Punk. Punk reverses, is able to get to the top rope, and he hits the elbow's a signature move for Punk. He hits the elbow, gets the pin. Punk was wrestling a wrestling match. Eddie Kingston was looking for a fight, and Punk has once again second match in a row.